Hey everyone, you're here with Mark Batwell at PerfectGardens.com. So today you're going to learn the three secrets to getting the best clones from your aeroponic cloner every single time. This video was inspired by one of our YouTube followers, Mr. Boyd. He asked, what should the perfect timer setting be for the best results with the same timer as shown in this video? I would recommend most likely to have a 15 minute on, 15 minute off cycle, although there are a few other factors I would highly recommend you consider prior to just going with that blanket answer of a 15 minute on, 15 minute off cycle. The first secret and thing to consider is the temperature of the water. The reason why the temperature of the water is the most important factor to comprehend and understand is because of the rate the bacteria multiplies based upon the temperature. The warmer the temperature, the faster that bacteria is going to multiply. Just like how when they learned the importance of washing your hands after an operation because of pathogens being transferred from one patient to the other, you have to kind of take that into consideration when you are getting clones. You are doing a surgical operation, you are exposing the plants to bacteria very quickly, and the temperature of your water and the speed at the rate the bacteria multiplies and the speed of the new roots coming off of the plant is incredibly important. If the bacteria takes hold first, you're going to get pythium or some type of issues. Although if you get the roots going first and the plant can begin to defend itself, you're more than likely going to get some successful clones. The temperature is going to come from three places: the ambient temperature in your room, the temperature off of your light, and the temperature off of the water pump. And that's where we go back to saying that the answer isn't as simple as just saying 15 minutes on and 15 minutes off, because the pump is not the only thing that's generating heat. If you have a warm ambient temperature or you have a light that's fairly close to the cloner and it's heating up your clone room, you're most likely going to get pythium no matter what, just because of, once again, the rate the bacteria multiplies and the likelihood that the bacteria took hold and gave your plant some type of disease before the plant began to put out roots. So it is so important to keep your water between 55 and 65 degrees. Anything higher, I guarantee you're going to get run into pythium. Anything lower than 55 degrees, your plants are going to get slower growth, and you're probably going to fall behind in the production numbers you need for your operation. So how do you control the ambient temperature of your room? First off, you have to ask yourself what type of environment is inside your grow room and outside of your grow room. Is there insulation? Some of the things that you can do to control your ambient temperature is get an AC for your room, or if you're living in a colder environment, make sure to have enough adequate air running in your room and exiting outside of your room. And in obviously early vegetative growth, they're not going to be producing any odor. So odor control is not going to be your focus here. It's going to be temperature control. Next is the heat coming off of your light. There's not much you can do here, except if you're using a high intensity discharge light, like a 250 watt or a 300 or 400 watt or something along those lines, you might be able to back that down to a T5, a 6500 Kelvin bulb. If not, just try to use the lowest setting on your high intensity discharge light. You might want to use a light diffuser, or just make sure not all that light is penetrating down on the casing of your clone system, heating up the water inside your cloner. And last but not least is your water pump. Make sure to just put it on a cycle, and you're going to want to know your grow room. If you have complete control of your environmental conditions and you're not using outside air to cool down your environment, and after a few times you run your aeroponic cloner, basically, you're just going to keep testing the temperature of your water throughout the day and throughout your cloning process, measuring your metrics and keeping track of it. And if things are getting above those 65 temperature or below 65, just adjust something in your grow room to get it to that ideal growing temperature for the cloning process. Secret number two is clean water. There are two ways to get clean water throughout your entire cloning process. You can use a hydrogen peroxide process, which basically oxygenates the water and it doesn't allow bacteria to grow. Second is using a product that I recommend called Drops of Balance. Drops of Balance is an ionic sulfate of mineral product that reverts man-made chemicals back to sulfate of minerals. So you're not just cleaning the water from bacteria with drops of balance, but you're also adding trace minerals into your water, which is kind of giving a very light nutrients. You can also use drops of balance in conjunction with the hydrogen peroxide. So if you wanted to use the hydrogen peroxide to kill all the bacteria, make sure you have a clean, sterile environment, and then add in drops of balance. At that point, once again, you're just adding minerals to your water, which will be a light micronutrients for your clones, which I would recommend just because I have seen the hyphae development start earlier when I use the product drops of balance versus just using the hydrogen peroxide to sterilize the water environment. Last but not least is your light cycle. What do you put on? 18-6, which means 18 hours on, 6 hours off, or a straight 24 hours when using the cloner. I personally recommend running your lights for 24 straight hours. The reason why is because your leaves do the photosynthesis, but they store the energy in the root system. And because you've done your clones and there's no root system for the first 5 to 7 days, there is no backup battery. So in my viewpoint, you kind of need the light to continuously keep producing energy for those clones. By doing that, it's going to keep sending the signal to the plant that it needs to store energy in the roots, which in my viewpoint will help encourage the plant to produce roots so that it can do its function, which is store sugars in the root system. In my viewpoint, when you put the light on for 18-6, for 6 hours, the plant is not signaling to itself, in my viewpoint, to produce roots. Because predominantly the plant does grow at nighttime, so it will then take the sugars from its root system and process them to grow. But because you don't have a root system, in my viewpoint, I wouldn't be encouraging the plant to grow. I'd be encouraging the plant to produce roots. If you do not have an aeroponic cloner currently right now, I would highly recommend to check out perfectgardens.com. We have a 12 site, 24 site, 30 site, 35 site, 70 site, an 84 site, and 140 site cloner. It does not matter what size operation you have. If you have a smaller operation, I would recommend just going straight to perfectgardens.com and checking out our cloners. If you need more than one or two cloners, I would highly recommend to check out our membership site. It's the best way to save money. So let's say if you needed to drop $10,000 in hydroponic equipment, all it's going to cost you is an additional $500 on retail side besides shipping and handling.
And have a great grow, everyone. Please like, share, and subscribe.